hateful liberals said it couldn't be done, but Trump just landed his biggest victory. When Donald Trump promised to bring back jobs, people scoffed. So-called experts claim that the billionaire businessman would never make good on his promise. Boy, were they wrong. In 2017 alone, he helped restore the U.S. economy to new heights. President Trump is ensuring that Americans will have ample opportunity to earn their living. This year is shaping up to be as successful, thanks to a big announcement. Americans have been losing jobs for decades. Companies have been seeking greener pastures overseas. They have shut down U.S. plants, moving operations to other countries. Sometimes to countries as close as Mexico. Harsh conditions, including abusive unions and skyrocketing taxes, have made doing business in America almost impossible. But, not anymore. President Trump has been restoring confidence in our economy since he entered office. Even before the landmark tax cut bill, he's been bringing back jobs. His executive order to slash government regulation has saved companies money in big ways. He's negotiated deals with foreign countries that encourage new investment in our economy. That's not to mention the simple confidence by consumers and businesses that we have a competent commander-in-chief. There's yet more good news. In keeping with a growing trend, a major car manufacturer just announced big investments in the United States. Toyota Mazda will build a $1.6 billion factory in Alabama. It will create thousands of new, great-paying jobs. Are you tired of winning yet? On Wednesday at an event at the RSA Activity Center, Governor Kay Ivey, RL, made it official when she announced Toyota Mazda would be building a $1.6 billion factory in northern Alabama's Limestone County outside of Huntsville. "Today is indeed a great day in the state of Alabama," Ivey proclaimed. "As governor, it is my honor and privilege to announce that Mazda and Toyota have chosen Alabama as the home of their new production plant." The announcement was met with a stand ovation just blocks from the Alabama state capitol, where legislators are convening the state's annual legislative session. The plan will add 4,000 new jobs with average salaries of $50,000 annually, and the plan will have the capacity to produce 300,000 cars annually. Source: Breitbart. Projects like this just don't create new manufacturing jobs. They create a ripple effect that impacts the entire economy. A variety of jobs will be created, thanks to this plant. The increase in production and activity in that area will expand throughout the country. Companies, communities, and families of all stripes will benefit from this major development. It's not just worth celebrating, in and of itself. Companies around the world are watching this announcement. When they see a major company like Toyota investing over $1 billion in the U.S. economy, they will be encouraged to do the same. We will see more businesses looking towards America for their next project. Thanks to less regulation, lower taxes, and consumer confidence, the United States is quickly becoming the best place to grow a business again. It's about time. Of course, the president was quick to announce the achievement. "Cutting taxes and simplifying regulations makes America the place to invest." Great news as Toyota and Mazda announce they are bringing 4,000 jobs and investing $1.6 billion in Alabama, helping to further grow our economy. Trump tweeted on Wednesday. Critics will be quick to downplay this development, but do you really think we would be seeing these victories if Hillary Clinton had been elected president? Under the Democrats, our economy only shrinks. Their stiff regulation, heavy taxes, and bloated government only hurt our industries. Companies would have continued to leave. More people would be out of work. The left would then make excuses and demand more government spending. The Toyota Mazda announcement is just one in a long line of similar victories. Don't be surprised when you hear more in the weeks and months to come. It's yet more proof that Donald Trump meant what he said about making America great again.